So let me set out now what is being asked. Firstly, we want to keep businesses open, but to help achieve this, we are asking them to step up the protections in place in their premises. We intend to amend regulations to put a legal requirement on those running businesses or providing services to take measures which are reasonably practicable to minimise the risk of transmission. We will issue guidance this week to make clear what that means for different sectors. For example, in retail, it will involve a return to the kind of protections in place at the start of the pandemic, for example, measures to avoid crowding and bottlenecks. This will include physical distancing, measures to control the flow of customers and protective screens. For hospitality, it will mean, for example, measures to avoid crowding at bars and between tables and a reminder of the requirement to collect contact details of customers to help with contact tracing. For employers more generally, the guidance will make clear that enabling staff who were working from home at the start of the pandemic to do so again is now a legal duty. I am hugely grateful to employers who are already allowing staff to work at home where possible, but we are not yet maximising the impact of home working to reduce the overall number of contacts we are having. We recognise, of course, that there are people who cannot work from home, for example, those who work in manufacturing, hospitality and key public services. We're asking anyone in this position to test regularly before going to work. We have extended the workplace testing scheme, which delivers lateral flow kits twice a week to all businesses who have signed up to it. I would encourage, urge indeed, any business with 10 or more employees to join up and encourage staff to test regularly. We will also be reinforcing the rules and public health messaging on the importance of wearing face coverings and wearing face coverings properly. Presiding Officer, my hardest request today is of the general public. I want to be clear, I am not asking anyone to cancel Christmas, but in the run-up to and in the immediate aftermath of Christmas, I am asking everyone to reduce as far as possible and to a minimum the contacts we have with people in other households, and I will say more about Christmas Day in a moment. We are not banning or restricting household mixing in law as before. We understand the negative impact this has on mental health and wellbeing. But we are asking everyone, and we will issue strong guidance to this effect, to cut down as far as possible the number of people outside our own households that we are interacting with just now. This will help break transmission chains. So my key request today is this: before and immediately after Christmas, please minimise your social mixing with other households as much as you can. However, if you do plan on socialising, either at home or in indoor public places, we are asking that you limit the number of households represented in your group to a maximum of three and make sure you test before you go. I know this is a tough thing to ask people to do, especially at this time of year. So I want to be clear why we are making this request. One of the things we have already learned about Omicron is that it has a very high attack rate. This means that if just one person in a gathering is infectious, that person is likely to infect many more people in the group than is the case with the Delta variant. So by reducing the numbers of people in households gathering together, we help limit the extent of its spread. Turning to Christmas Day specifically, or Christmas Eve or Boxing Day, or whenever you have your main family celebration, we are not asking you to cancel or change your plans, and we are not proposing limits on the size of household gatherings. Places of worship will also remain open with appropriate mitigations. But we will issue guidance to help you make Christmas safer. Reducing your contacts in advance of and after Christmas, as I have just strongly advised, will help do this. Keeping your celebrations as small as your family circumstances allow is sensible too. Make sure everyone in your gathering is vaccinated and has done a test in advance. Keep rooms ventilated and follow strict hygiene rules. Presiding Officer, I know how much I am asking of everyone today after a difficult and painful 2 years. I would not be doing so if I did not believe it to be absolutely necessary. Indeed, it could be argued that we should be going further, which is why I need to also explain a significant limitation on our ability to act in the way we think necessary to protect public health. And in this context, I am genuinely not seeking to make a political point, simply to set out the factual position. Many of the protections that help curtail COVID come at a financial cost to individuals and businesses. So wherever we can, we put in place financial packages to protect people's health, jobs and livelihoods. However, the Scottish, Welsh and Northern Ireland governments do not have the ability to borrow to meet the COVID funding challenge. UK funding arrangements mean we rely on the Treasury to do so on our behalf, and the Treasury has responded well throughout this pandemic. And although Scottish taxpayers foot our share of the bill, money only flows to the devolved governments when the UK government makes decisions. Financial support is not triggered if the devolved governments take decisions we consider appropriate for public health reasons, even though it is our responsibility to do so. So because the UK government is at this stage not proposing any further protections, a position I do not agree with, there is no funding generated to compensate businesses for any protections we think are necessary and wish to put in place. That is not acceptable in current circumstances, and with the Welsh and Northern Irish governments, we are pressing for a fairer approach that takes account of our devolved responsibilities for protecting public health. But for now, this is the situation we are in, and it means our public health response is curtailed by lack of finance. There are further steps we could and would have considered today, particularly around hospitality, had we the financial ability to do so, but we don't. However, I can confirm that with some considerable difficulty, we have managed to identify within our own resources around £100 million that we will use to help businesses, mainly those in hospitality and food supply and in the culture sector, affected by our advice last week on work Christmas parties and further affected by what I have said today. The Finance Secretary and her officials will be engaging with affected sectors immediately to consult on and confirm the details of support. We will work to make money available as soon as possible. Businesses who previously received support through the Strategic Business Framework Business Fund will be contacted directly. We have also identified an additional £100 million to ensure the self-isolation support grant is available for those who need it, given the expected increase in the number of eligible people who will be asked to isolate. Making this money available will involve difficult reprioritisation, but we recognise the importance of providing as much help as we possibly can. However, this is the limit of what we are able to do within our own resources. I know it does not go far enough in compensating businesses for what we are asking of them now, and of course no government can rule out having to go further in the weeks ahead. So we are continuing to press the UK government to increase support to enable us to respond adequately to the public health challenges in the weeks ahead.